Hello guys, it's your girl Onana, and this is Onana Nation. So if you're new here, a very special welcome to you. Please go ahead and subscribe as we dive into today's topic. So today we're going to be talking about Cameroonian champ Francis Ngannou, who just won UFC World Heavyweight Champion. So today he had the chance to go back home and present his belt to his mama first and foremost, and then to the community. So this is Ngannou being given a hero's welcome, and it's funny to think that this guy was in the same place just a few years ago, could not even afford money for basic necessities. Today he's going back as a millionaire, going to make his mama proud, going to present his belt to his mama like, mama, we made it, yay, the Lord has smiled on us. So I just feel like a proud sister, like, hey, I'm claiming relationship today, I'm not begging you guys. I feel like a proud sister, a proud distant cousin, okay? So we're so happy for Ngannou. Like, this is such a come up, man. This is such a big flex. When you go out there and you hustle, you want to come back and show mommy, like, hey, mama, we made it. You want to make the community proud. So this is a guy whom yesterday was a nobody in Cameroon, but today, thanks to the grace of God and thanks to determination and hard work, has gone out there and made a name for himself. And coming back to the country today, they are receiving him like a hero. This would not have been the case if he was just coming back like a normal bush faller, but because he has gone and made Cameroon proud, he's coming back today. He's a proud son of the soil. We are all happy for him. See all this crowd, everybody's coming out chanting his name, Ngannou, Ngannou, Ngannou part two. So we are all proud of him today as he goes back home to celebrate with his mom and then with the community. You see what we're saying? Today he has access to governor's offices. That's the governor of the Littoral region giving him a good welcome. The whole governor's quarters, everybody welcoming him. He's having access to all these people today just because of who he is. So in this life, Hozulu, my people, Hozulu, all these people that will not grant you access, all these rich people, all these ministers, all the presidents that do not want to see you, there's a level of success that you have that people be inviting you all over on national TV to the presidency. Who are you, a regular boy, to want to have an audience with Bia? You're a nobody. But when God blesses you, the president himself is the one who calls you and wants you in the presidential palace. And if you tell him, oh, I'm busy, he sends a jet to come and pick you up and go meet him. So we thank God for this level of success. I mean, our brother today is a household name. Everybody wants to rub shoulders with him. Everybody wants to claim they know him. Everybody wants to claim relationship. And that's just success for you. Once you make it, everybody wants to show that, hey, I went to primary school with this person. I went to secondary school with this person. I know them. I know him. So it's amazing the things success will do. What success will make people do. Success will bring people to you. Even the ones who do not want to see you, they'll come back now and start claiming relationship and all that. So Ngannou just has to be careful, you know, stick to your people. I'm particularly proud of the fact that he takes his mama everywhere with him. That's a proud mom and son moment. Now, when the son recognizes all the hard work the mom had done for him, struggling to sell makara banana, struggling to sell banga bush, like Elizabeth Teke, just to take care of him. Like, I like a grateful man. I like a grateful son. I like a mama's boy, and he's such a mama's boy. It's amazing, really. There are some mothers who struggle for their children, and when their children want to become successful, the cold hands of death will snatch the mama away. But I'm happy for him. In his own case, his mama is still alive, and mama gets to enjoy from her son's wealth. We thank God for them. It's a beautiful moment for the Ngannou family in general, for his village, and for the entire Cameroon. Why not Africa? So we are proud of these superstars that are coming out of Africa. It's an amazing thing. Our names are being heard. Our voices are being heard. We are being represented. It's beautiful. Congratulations to young Ngannou on your new success. We hope you create Ngannou Foundation in Cameroon where you can teach young kids, to introduce them to boxing. Boxing is not really a big sport in Cameroon. In Cameroon, most people want to do soccer because of Samuel Eto'o. Most people want to do basketball. Most people want to do football, you know, because of Noah and all those people. If you introduce boxing in Cameroon, you can create a boxing center, a boxing academy. It will be amazing. That would be a fantastic way of giving back to your community. You can create a boxing prize that you go back every year, a yearly boxing prize, the best boxing student. Maybe you take them back with you to the US or whatever. You give them opportunities to sign them in your own boxing academy or boxing label. I don't know how you're going to make that work, but that would be an amazing way to give back to the community. Again, we cannot dictate terms to you. I mean, you are the boss of your life and only you can do what you want to do. We are just suggesting, we are just recommending, you know. If that's something you want to look into, that would be amazing. I mean, that would be such a great way to help these kids in Cameroon who are getting crazy by the day. If you guys have been watching the news in Cameroon, you must have seen that schools in Cameroon are getting crazy. Kids are fighting each other in school, memeing each other. Just yesterday, at Lycée de Loom, a kid cut off their friend's hand. They were quarreling, they were arguing. I don't know what was over a girl. He cut off his classmate's arm. So you can see how kids are going crazy. And every day we're seeing pictures and videos of kids who are fighting their students in school, fighting their teachers and all that stuff. Some of them are even making love in classrooms. So you can see how children are gradually losing their minds in Cameroon. Juvenile delinquency is the order of the day. Kids are fighting each other and all that stuff. They're really going backwards morally. So if this is your way of giving back to the community, that would be amazing. I mean, we're calling on all successful Cameroonians to use whatever little platforms they have to reach out to the youth. The youth particularly, these are the ones that need saving. They need to get off the streets. They need to get off the back of violence. They need to focus, have all these moral values, and you know, it'll be an amazing place in the future. So I guess I've said my piece. On that note, we've come to the end of today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I remain your girl Onana. If you're new here, please subscribe, like, and comment. Please guys, tell me what you think about this video in the comment section below, and don't forget to share the video. So now I'm going to leave video clips from Gano's welcome. You know, he went to the governor's office, he was granted a press conference, he went to MTN, he has been so many places, people were just welcoming him everywhere. So I'm going to put the video now so you guys can watch. You know, he speaks in French too, so you guys can watch that. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Goodbye.
Monsieur le gouverneur, une fois de plus, merci au directeur de MTN et tout le groupe, à tout le groupe MTN et les dirigeants MTN. Merci à la population, aux médias, à tous ceux qui ont pris la peine de se présenter ici ce soir. Parce que depuis cet après-midi, on est tous ensemble, on fait la tournée. Bon, on est fatigué, mais bon. Quand il y a la fête, on n'entend pas la fatigue, c'est après qu'on va gérer ça. Et après, on va la fête continue.
Merci.
Bien, madame.
Yellow, si vous nous rejoignez, nous avons eu une légère interruption. Oui, connectez-vous, partagez le direct. Vous êtes en direct de Douala, partagez le direct, si vous nous rejoignez. Nous avons eu une légère interruption. Mais ceci n'enlève en rien la liesse, la joie, l'engouement, oui, tout cet amour que les populations de Douala sont en train de témoigner à Francis Xavier Nganou. Partagez le direct et dites à tous ceux qui étaient connectés de revenir que désormais nous sommes de nouveau en ligne et nous approchons. Alors là, je célèbre le mythique Carrefour de Koti. Si vous voyez actuellement, nous avons traversé André Payel, nous avons traversé l'université de Douala. Et de plus en plus, les bicyclistes, les chauffeurs de moto, les mototaxis se rajoutent de plus en plus pour accompagner le champion. Celui-là qui est désormais le champion du monde de mixed martial arts. Lui, je sous-entends par là le MMA, c'est Francis Xavier Nganou, désormais imbattable. Désormais, c'est le monde entier qui veut récupérer cette ceinture. Cette ceinture-là qui se trouve actuellement au Cameroun. Le monde entier recherche cette ceinture parce que Francis Xavier Nganou, non, il ne l'a pas volé. Non, il a dû se battre depuis qu'il est tout petit pour pouvoir réaliser son rêve. Il s'est battu tous les jours un peu plus malgré les difficultés. Jamais il n'a baissé les bras. Aujourd'hui, il est le champion du monde. Vous voyez cette ceinture en or. Vous voulez la toucher? Descendez, sortez de chez vous. Parce que Francis arrive, préparez votre téléphone, faites des selfies. MTN Cameroun a décidé de vous faire vivre un moment à jamais inoubliable. Le 26 avril 2021, le 26 avril 2021, notez bien cette date, jamais plus elle ne sortira des annales. Le 26 avril 2021, une ceinture en or, poids lourd, catégorie poids lourd de l'IFC est arrivée au Cameroun. Les Camerounais l'ont vu, les Camerounais ont célébré tout ceci grâce à un Camerounais qui s'est battu fort, fort et âme, Francis Xavier Nganou. Comme lui, tous les abonnés de notre réseau, vous êtes tous des imbattables. Alors partagez le direct, partagez, appelez les autres afin qu'ils puissent eux aussi venir regarder, célébrer avec toutes les populations de Douala. Que tout le Cameroun puisse voir ça, que c'est un Camerounais qui a porté très haut, vraiment très haut, les couleurs, le vert ou jaune du Cameroun.